of you have a list of things to ask Allah Azza wa Jal in dua. Okay, so we have a number of people who did do the write a paper with the things we now want to ask Allah Azza wa Jal. Okay, I want to remind us all, it's not too late. Why not too late? Because Allah Azza wa Jal of Ramadan is Allah Azza wa Jal of outside of Ramadan. So this list is not only for Ramadan, this list is for forever. Just to remind you of what you need to be asking Allah Azza wa Jal. And then when you write this list, you might find that some things you are hesitant on wanting to ask Allah Azza wa Jal. Meaning, an example. So you might write in your list, I want to ask Allah Azza wa Jal to get this job. Specific job. Then you look at it. I'm not sure this job is good for me. Maybe it's not good for me. So you remove it from this list and put it in another list of istikhara, of asking Allah Azza wa Jal guidance on which way to go. Okay. So writing the list is important because, as I said, first of all, to remind you to always do du'a because you want all these things. So you will be reminded to always do du'a. This is one thing. Another thing, while writing it, you will find that some things, yes, this might should go to the istikhara list, not to the du'a list, and so on and so forth. And istikhara is du'a, of course, is one kind of du'a. So I encourage you, it's never too late. Just now, after we finish this, get out your mobile and write this list. There's a very short hadith. Aisha reported that Allah's Messenger said in Arabic, حَبُّ الْأَعْمَالِ إِلَى اللَّهِ أَدْوَمُهَا وَإِنْ قَلْ. In English, the acts most pleasing to God or to Allah are those which are done most consistently and continuously, even if they amount too little. This hadith is in both Bukhari and Muslim. Okay, so the acts that are most pleasing to Allah is the ones you are most consistent with. I'm saying this now, why? Because we are about to leave Ramadan. And one thing we need to do is to use our current state of faith, which is alhamdulillah good, or as good as it gets. Okay, use it to make certain decisions for life after Ramadan. How will Ramadan change your life? How will you come out of Ramadan better than you entered Ramadan? One of the signs that Ramadan, that our good deeds in Ramadan have been accepted by Allah Azza wa Jal, is to actually come out of Ramadan better than we entered Ramadan. Okay? So how do we come out of Ramadan better than we entered Ramadan? By doing things after Ramadan that we hadn't been doing before Ramadan. That's one perspective. Another perspective is not doing things that we were doing before Ramadan. Stop doing them after Ramadan. Okay? Here, this hadith with us gives us a very important rule when thinking about which thing, what to choose and how to choose it, how much. For example, one might say, oh, I didn't do Qiyam before Ramadan. I didn't do any sort of night prayer after Isha. I usually slept without doing any prayer. Okay, that was my habit. One thing I want to change after Ramadan is that I want to do night prayer. Okay, this hadith teaches us when you want to start doing it, don't have too high ambitions from the beginning. You can have very high ambition, but reach this ambition gradually. So you come out of Ramadan, okay, I'll do two rak'ahs and one rak'ah witr. Just that. And each rak'ah, I'll pray half a page. Half a page of the Mus'haf. Okay, how much time will this take? This will take maybe 5 minutes. Okay. By the way, this words of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the advice of people currently in psychology. There is this example for the there's a book called how do I forgot the name? It's by Dan and Chip Heath. I don't remember the name now. It's about change, okay? In it, they say if you have a teenager son daughter, and the room is very very bad, like the room is very messy, everything is all over each other and so on and so forth, and you tell them go clean your room, what will they do? They will not clean it. If you are living alone, okay, and your room is extremely bad, and you tell yourself, I want to clean my room, what will happen? You will not clean it, you will leave it. You will leave it untidy and leave it as is. So they do a trick. They tell yourself, I will clean my room for 5 minutes a day, every day. Just 5 minutes, only 5 minutes a day, every day, just 5 minutes, okay? The most important thing is never miss what? Never miss a day, but just 5 minutes. And once the clock comes 5 minutes, what do you do? If you have a book in your hand that you're going to put on the shelf, leave it on the floor like it was. Just 5 minutes. Just 5 minutes. What will happen after 2 weeks? Your room will be clean. Maybe, just maybe, maybe in while doing it, one day you will find energy, so you'll finish it up. Maybe one day. But your rule is 5 minutes a day, every day. That's it. So, application now to our أدوامه وإنقل, the most pleasing to Allah of أعمال, of acts, of deeds, is the most consistent. So, you don't have قيام ليل, insert قيام ليل in life and don't miss it one day. Okay? And I'll tell you also another trick. Another trick. Okay, I'll leave the trick for a bit, okay? I'll tell it, but maybe in 2 minutes, okay? Okay, I used to pray in the mosque just one prayer per day. Make them two. Or make it 3 days a week, one prayer, and 4 days a week, two prayers in the mosque. Okay? So increase. You can make your habits daily habits, and you can make your habits weekly habits. One of the very important habits, to read in the Mus'haf, read in the Quran. Arabic for your tongue and English for the meaning. That's very important habit. You can make it weekly habit, not necessarily daily habit or daily habit, whatever. Okay? So now at least you have three things, right? And you can have four and five and six, and you should think about these things. I'm telling you one of the important ones. These are very important things that will help you increase your deen, increase your religion, but you need to think about your own things, okay? Now the trick. I encourage you to download an app on your mobile, whether it's iPhone or Android, okay? That does habit tracking. There are many habit trackers, tracking apps online. Lots of apps. I'm an Android user. I use a very easy and simple app called Loop. It's an open source app. You can download your data and everything, okay? In this app, what you do is what? You insert the habit you want to track. Track your habit, okay? You insert this habit. And then on a daily basis, you start putting whether you did it or not. Your objective is to do it daily. Okay, the first month passed and it seemed like you did it 20 times instead of 30. Very good, you have an objective for next month. What's your objective for next month?
25.
Instead of 20 out of 30, make it 25 out of 30 and so on. When you start feeling that one of the habits has started to get rooted and is now part of your life, Add another habit. At a point in time, you can have like 10, 15 habits, mashallah, you've inserted on your... This is not simply technology or something new or something. The author, James Clear, of the book Atomic Habits wrote, that's a very, very famous book about habits. It's called Atomic Habits. or mini habits or whatever. Many books are about habits, okay? Or The Power of Habits by Charles Duhigg. These are lots of books about habits. These are not tricks from them. These are tricks from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his companions. حاسبوا أنفسكم قبل أن تحاسبوا. So hold yourself accountable before you are held accountable in front of Allah Azza wa Jal on the day of judgment. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد. O believers, be cautious of Allah Azza wa Jal and look, watch, observe, beware of what you have prepared for tomorrow, the longer tomorrow, the infinite tomorrow. Okay? So this act of holding yourself accountable is extremely important. As such, there is a very important habit of actually, on a daily basis, what? Logging, like clicking, I did this. My sheikh is now, I think, 65, 66. I don't know how old he is. He's been doing his own tracking before mobiles. Before mobiles, years before mobiles, maybe 45 years now he's doing it or more. He does it with paper. Daily, he tracks the important things that he needs to track. Tracking his habits. Habit by habit, you change your life with Allah Azza wa Jal. What I'm saying is blend between self-help books and Sharia and Deen, okay? It's a blend between both. But it's extremely important, extremely practical. This is practical. This is practical things. Do not go out of Ramadan without a plan of being better than you enter Ramadan. A practical plan. I recommend, number one, Qiyamul Layl. Prayer at night. Prayer at night entails Quran, entails Dhikr, entails prayer itself, and entails Dua. It is opportunity for you to put your head on the ground and ask Allah Azza wa Jalla when you're closest to Him. Okay? Prayer at night need not be necessarily before Fajr, because you can be too ambitious and say, I want to do my prayer in the last third of the night when Allah Azza wa Jalla comes to earth and so on and so. No. If you fear that you might not wake up, pray it before you sleep. Pray it. Okay? Two rak'ahs, qiyam. Half a page in each rak'ah, and one rak'ah utr. If you already do that before Ramadan, do more. Whatever you were, level you were at, increase it. Okay, this is a must. Okay, another is increasing your leg on the mosque, on the masjid, regardless what it was. You were, so we have 5 times 7 is 35, right? You used to get 80%, right? Make it 85%. Make it better. Okay? More. You used to get 95%, 99%. You miss sometimes. Okay. Do more time. Spend time between Fajr and Shuruq. Go to a level up. Spend time in from Fajr and Shuruq 3 days a week. Maybe weekend or weekdays. So improve your relationship with Allah, improve the good deeds you are doing. Just have this, please. I am advising myself before I'm advising you. Sit by yourself with your mobile phone, note application, or pen and paper, okay? And write, I plan to do 1, 2, 3. Okay, and hold yourself accountable to that. Before Allah Azza wa Jal holds you accountable to everything you've done in your whole life. جزاكم الله خيرا والحمد لله رب العالمين.